So, hey friends, today we are going to do the human histology's revision. Okay. So, this one is the hyaline cartilage, and hyaline means glass. Okay, so here you can see the fibrous layer, the cellular layer that forms the perichondrium, chondrocyte in lacunae, territorial matrix, cell nest, interterritorial matrix. Okay, so now the points. Hyaline cartilage is characterized by isogenous groups of chondrocytes called cell nest. Chondrocytes are surrounded by homogeneous basophilic matrix which separates the cells widely. Chondrocytes increase in size from periphery to center. Near the surface of the cartilage, the cells are flattened and merged with the cells of the overlying connective tissues. The connective tissue forms the perichondrium. Perichondrium displays an outer fibrous and inner cellular layer. So this was all about the hyaline cartilage. Now moving toward the cardiac muscle. Centrally placed nucleus, striations, intercalated disc for fast conduction, and branching cells. The fibers are made up of cells, each of which has a centrally placed nucleus and transverse striations. A clear space called perinuclear halo is seen around the nucleus. Adjacent cells are separated from one another by transverse lines called intercalated discs. Fibers show branching. Blood vessels are also seen. Now the histology of the liver. Interlobular ducts, Kupffer cells, nucleus of sinusoid, endothelial, hepatocyte plate, central vein, hepatic sinusoids. The lobule is made up of polygonal liver cells arranged in form of radiating cords. The central round nucleus of hepatocyte is surrounded by abundant pink cytoplasm. The cords are separated from each other by spaces called sinusoids. The sinusoids are lined by endothelial cells and Kupffer cells, macrophagic cells. Each portal tract contains a hepatic artery, portal venule, and one or two interlobular bile ducts. Normally, these structures are surrounded by fibroconnective tissue and a few lymphocytes. Now we are going to see the thyroid glands. Parafollicular cells, follicular cells, blood vessels, colloid, parathyroid. The thyroid gland is made up of follicles lined by cuboidal epithelium. In photomicrograph, in low magnification, it can be seen that follicles vary in shape and size. Each follicle is filled with a homogeneous pink colloidal proteinaceous material composed primarily of thyroglobulin that has been produced by the follicular epithelial cells. Parafollicular cells are present in relation to the follicles and are also grouped in connective tissue. In the interval between the follicles, there is some connective tissue and blood vessels between follicles. So this one is the thyroid gland. Okay. Now, lymph node, afferent lymphatic vessels, subscapular sinus, trabeculae, lymphatic nodule, medullary sinus, connective tissue, capsule, germinal center, paracortex, blood vessel, medullary cords. A thin capsule surrounds the lymph node and sends in trabeculae. Just beneath the capsule, a clear space is seen. This is the subscapular sinus. A lymph node has an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The cortex is packed with the lymphocytes. A number of rounded lymphatic follicles or nodules are present. Each nodule has a pale staining germinal center surrounded by a zone of densely packed lymphocytes. Within the medulla, the lymphocytes are arranged in form of anastomosing cords. Several blood vessels can be seen in the medulla. Now, spleen, germinal center, capsule, trabecula, white pulp, central artery, trabeculae blood vessels, red pulp, splenic cords. The spleen is characterized by a thick capsule with a trabeculae extending from into the organ. The substance of the organ is divided into the red pulp, into which there are diffusely distributed lymphocytes and numerous sinusoids, and the white pulp, in which dense aggregations of lymphocytes are present. The latter are in form of cords surrounding arterioles. When cut transversely, the cords resemble the lymphatic nodule of lymph nodes, and like them, they have germinal centers surrounded by rings of densely packed lymphocytes. However, the nodules of the spleen are easily distinguished from those of the lymph nodes because of the presence of an arteriole in each nodule. This arteriole occupies an eccentric position in the nodule. Now, optic nerve, dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Subarachnoid space containing the CSF, subdural space, optic nerve fibers, central retina, artery and vein, pial septum, covered by meninges, dura mater, arachnoid mater and pia mater, central retinal artery and vein are seen. Pial septa divides the nerves into bundles. Smooth muscles, longitudinal layer and circular layer. In longitudinal section, loose connective tissue is seen above and below the layers of muscle. The smooth muscle fibers are spindle-shaped cells and tapering ends. The nucleus is elongated and centrally placed. No striations are seen. In transverse section, the spindle-shaped cells are cut at different places along the length, resulting in various shapes and sizes of the cells. The nucleus is seen in those cells which are cut through the center. Others do not show nuclei. Now the elastic artery, vasa vasorum, tunica adventitia, external elastic lamina, endothelium, subendothelial connective tissue forms the tunica intima, internal elastic lamina, tunica media and elastic fibers. Elastic artery is characterized by presence of tunica intima consisting of endothelial, subendothelial connective tissue and internal elastic lamina. The first layer of the elastic lamina is called the internal elastic lamina. The internal elastic lamina is just indistinct from the elastic fiber of media. Well-developed subendothelial layers in tunica intima, thick tunica media with many elastic fibers and some smooth muscle fibers, tunica adventitia containing collagen fiber with several elastic fibers, vasa vasorum in the tunica adventitia not seen in this slide. Okay. Now the thin skin, sebaceous gland, longitudinal section of hair follicles, stratum corneum, epidermis, dermis, arrector, pili muscles, transverse section of hair follicle, sweat gland, adipose tissue. Presence of thin epidermis made up of keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, stratum corneum is thin. Hair follicles, sebaceous glands and sweat glands are present in the dermis. It is found in all other parts of the body except palms and soles. Now the thick skin, stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, epidermis, excretory ducts of sweat glands, dermal papillae, stratum basale, basement membrane and dermis. Presence of thick epidermis made up of keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, stratum corneum is very thick. Hair follicles and sebaceous glands are absent in dermis. Sweat glands are present in the dermis. It is found in palms of hands and soles of feet. Palms of hands and soles of feet contains thick skin. Palms of hand and sole. Renal medulla, high magnification, blood vessel, thin segment of loop of Henle, papillary duct, straight segment of distal tribune, connective tissue. A high power view of a part of the renal medulla shows a number of collecting ducts cut longitudinally or transversely. They are lined by a cuboidal epithelium, the cells of which stain lightly. Cells boundaries are usually distinct. The lumen of the tubule is also distinct. Sections of the thin segment of the loop of Henle are seen. They are lined by flattened cells that walls being very similar in appearance to those of the blood capillaries. Sections through the thick segments of loop of Henle are seen. They are lined by cuboidal epithelium. Now the trachea. Okay. Now the trachea, adipose cells, blood vessels, pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium and lamina propria, seromucous tracheal glands, perichondrium, haline cartilage, trachealis adventitia, pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium with goblet cells, pseudo-stratified ciliated columnar epithelium, trachea.
lamina propria, submucosa with serous and mucous glands, presence of feline cartilage and trachealis muscle. Lung, plates of feline cartilage, intrapulmonary bronchus, alveolar sac, respiratory bronchiole, terminal bronchiole, blood vessels, presence of alveolar ducts, alveolar sac lined by simple squamous epithelium, alveoli is lined by simple squamous epithelium, presence of intrapulmonary bronchus with varying amount of islands, cartilage and smooth muscles, respiratory bronchioles with simple cuboidal epithelium, lining lacking cilia and goblet cells. Now the esophagus, adipose tissue, blood vessels, adventitia, muscularis externa, submucosa, muscularis mucosa, lamina propria. Lining epithelium of the esophagus is a stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. Four layer of gastrointestinal tract, GIT, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa, adventitia C. Lining epithelium is a stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. Submucosa is studded with mucus secreting esophageal glands. Okay. Now, 1 minute. Renal cortex high magnification, juxtaglomerular apparatus, distal convoluted tubule, proximal convoluted tubule, Bowman's capsule, urinary space, glomerulus. In the high power view of the renal cortex, large renal corpuscles can be identified. The renal corpuscles consist of tuft of capillaries that form a rounded glomerulus and an outer wall, the glomerular capsule, Bowman's capsule. A urinary space between the glomerulus and the capsule is seen. Proximal convoluted tubules are dark staining. They are lined by cuboidal cells with a prominent brush border. The lumen is indistinct. Distal convoluted tubules are lighter staining. The cuboidal cells lining them do not have a brush border. The lumen is indistinct. Stomach, fundus, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa, gastric pits, surface epithelium, parietal cells, chief cells, gland cells, gastric glands, muscularis mucosa, blood vessels, oblique and circular and longitudinal muscle layer. Presence of four layer mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa and serosa. Shallow gastric pits occupying surface 1/4 or less of the mucus. Presence of gastric glands in the mucosa. Gastric glands and numerous oxyntic cells which are beaded appearance. Now the duodenum. Duodenum, crypts of liver, villi, space epithelium, lamina propria, muscularis mucosa, submucosa having Bruner's gland, blood vessels, inner circular muscle layer, outer longitudinal muscle layer, serosa. Wall made up of four layers, mucosa, presence of numerous broad villi lined by simple columnar epithelium with microvilli and goblet cells. Presence of submucosal gland, Bruner's gland. Okay. Ileum. Mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa. Lining epithelium, villus, goblet cells, lamina propria, Peyer's patches, muscularis mucosa, inner circular and outer longitudinal layer, muscle layer. Wall made up of four layers. Mucosa, presence of short, small, fewer villi lined by simple columnar epithelium with microvilli and numerous goblet cells. Absence of submucosa, Bruner's gland. Uterus proliferative phase. Stratum functionalis, stratum basalis. Lining epithelium, uterine gland, lamina propria, stroma, blood vessels, smooth muscle, cross section, smooth muscle, longitudinal and blood vessels. The wall of the uterus consists of mucous membrane called the endometrium and a very thick layer of muscle, the myometrium. The thickness of the muscle layer helps to identify the uterus easily. The endometrium has a lining of columnar epithelium that rests on the stroma or the connective tissue. Numerous tubular uterine glands dips into the stroma. The appearance of the endometrium varies considerably depending upon the phase of the menstrual cycle. The endometrium is thin and progressively increases in thickness. The uterine glands are straight and tubular in this phase. Now the colon, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa. Lining epithelium with numerous goblet cells, lamina propria, muscularis mucosa, blood vessels, lymphatic follicle, inner circular, outer longitudinal muscle layer, and tinea coli. Colon is containing tinea coli. This one. Okay. Wall made up of four layers. Mucosa, absence of villi, lined by simple columnar epithelium with numerous goblet cells. Lymphatic follicles dispersed in the lamina propria. Presence of tinea coli. Appendicitis, epiplotsiae. Jejunum, mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa. Villus, lining epithelium, lamina propria, goblet cells, muscularis mucosa, inner circular, outer longitudinal, smooth muscle layer. Wall made up of four layers. Mucosa, presence of numerous tall cylinder villi, lined by simple columnar epithelium with microvilli and goblet cells.
Jejunum contains microvilli also.
Now, absence of submucosa Brunner's gland,
but the Brunner's gland is absent in the jejunum. Okay. Now the ovary.
Ovary, cortex, corpus luteum, medulla, blood vessels, corpus albicans, germinal epithelium, primordial follicle, graafian follicle, turiga albuginea, secondary follicle. The surface is covered by cuboidal epithelium. Deep through the epithelium, there is a layer of connective tissue that constitutes the turiga albuginea. The substance of the ovary has an outer cortex in which follicles of various size are present, and an inner medulla consists of connective tissue containing numerous blood vessels. Just deep through the turiga albuginea, many primordial follicles, each of which contains a developing ovum surrounded by flattened follicular cells, are present. Large follicles have a follicular cavity surrounded by several layers of follicular cells. The cells surrounding the ovum constitute the cumulus oophorus. The follicle is surrounded by condensation of connective tissue, which forms a capsule for it. The capsule consists of an inner cellular part, the theca interna, and an outer fibrous part, the theca externa, collectively called the theca folliculi. The follicle is surrounded by stroma made up of reticular fibers and fugiform cells. Uterus, secretory phase, stratum functionalis, stratum basale, lining epithelium, lamina propria, blood vessels, tortuous uterine glands, smooth muscles, cross-sectional and smooth muscle longitudinal. The thickness of the endometrium is much increased. The uterine glands elongate, become dilated and tortuous, as a result of which they have sawtooth margin in the sections. Blood vessels extends in the upper portion of the endometrium.
So this was all about the human histology, and you can see all, I will give the picture in this video, the histology slides. Okay, so all the best.